you could leave your child with any Disney character, who would you leave your child with?
Probably the fairy godmother.
Wow, that's probably the correct answer.
I know. I'm like, who's responsible enough to watch my kid? Like, I'm thinking about who watches my kid, as you'll find out.
Yeah, I was going to go with Elliot from Pete's Dragon, but...
I think fairy godmother would be the only one on my list.
Well, you're afraid that the child will come back singing Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo the whole time?
No, I'd be fine with that.
Okay. Of course. Boom, boom, akalaka laka boom. Welcome to another Believe Vacations interview. My name is Brian Pavlick. I have a wonderful agent friend of mine, Miss Kira Ashline. She is going to go over a wonderful topic with us tonight that I don't think a lot of people know about. She told us about it on her recent trip, and we were like, we have to do an interview with this. So first of all, Kira, good evening. How are you tonight?
I'm great, Brian. How are you?
You know, hanging out with my boys in the Country Bear Jamboree, all is well in Birmingham, and we just got back from a Believe Vacations team trip. You went a few weeks prior. And while we went mostly as adults, there were some family members. When you went, you took your child and you experienced something that a lot of people are not really familiar with. We're going to talk about it tonight. Basically, she did Kids Nite Out. And it is a lot of fun. We're going to learn so much about it tonight. So I hope that you are going to learn a lot and maybe even take advantage of it when you go down. Kira's going to tell you about the child side of it, the adult side of it, and all the in or outs of it. But first, we got to know who Kira is. All right. She's been with Believe for a hot minute. So it's not like we've got somebody who just joined. She's been with us. Kira, just tell a little bit about who you are, where you are in the world, and how long you've been with Believe, if you don't mind.
So I am in Springfield, Mass. So I'm the only Believe agent in the Northeast. I'm pretty sure. But I lived in Florida for a while. I've lived in Tennessee, so I've kind of been all over the place. I know it as a local. I worked on property for Hilton, so I have that background, but I'm also in healthcare and I am a single mom to a 2-year-old. And we like to go as often as we can. And to make it special for myself, I obviously took advantage of this. So because I also needed to do Disney the way I used to do it.
That's fun. See, it's not, we were talking off camera about being for adults and all that. And yes, it's for kids, but man, when you turn Disney into an adult adventure, it's just as fun. It's just as magical. And we highly encourage it here at Believe Vacations. So we're going to get into Kira's experience here. But as she mentioned, she's up in Massachusetts. And of course, we've got agents all over. But you don't have to be in Massachusetts to use Kira. In fact, I've run all your contact information at the bottom. So if you see Kira, if you learn about this, even if it's not about Kids Nite Out, if it's just questions because of her expertise, reach out to her. She'd love to either talk to you, answer some questions, and of course, book your next travel vacation, whether it is through Disneyland, Disney World, Cruise Line, all the things that we offer. So, but tonight we are talking about Kids Nite Out. Can you believe it? Disney offers Kids Nite Out, and Kira found it, took advantage of it. Let's jump right into it, Kira. What exactly is it? And how did you find it?
So Kids Nite Out is basically babysitting service. They are contracted through Disney, so they're not actually Disney, but they're contracted. I just happened to be looking on the website, the Go Disney, and came across it, wanted to find out if it was even active with the COVID situation, didn't know what was going on. So I think it was their email that was on there. So I sent an email asking about it. They responded within, I think it was less than 24 hours. I don't think it was very long at all. And they told me how to go about it. So basically what it is, they'll come to your room. They'll go somewhere with your child. They'll even do like basically a mother or father's helper in the theme park.
Wonderful.
So that's part of all their fees and everything. They have different fees for different things, but honestly, my experience with it was fantastic. I loved it. And yeah, so that's what it is. It's babysitting.
So they have a website service. I assume the fees and everything are on the, or do you, will they tell you the fees once you kind of ask what service and what your kind of requirement is?
So the fees are pretty much listed. Okay. All new. They are spelled out. There's different additional fees. So like one kid is a base fee. Okay. And then each other kid is a little bit more. So honestly, people with like four or more kids are actually making out with it because paying the least. Things like holidays are like an extra premium. What other things? Marathon. They cover.
Ooh, good point.
They cover marathon babysitting, so they can start as early as 3 a.m. during marathon times, which is great for those who are running and don't have somebody to watch their kid. Hey, me, back to my run. It's nice to know that that option is available.
Right.
They can start as early as 6:30 in the morning. They can go. They can start as late as 11 p.m. They work 24/7. So if you wanted an overnight or something like that, it is available.
Wonderful. Stay with that on if you don't mind for a second. So let's just talk about, and I know you're going to talk about your specific thing, but if it was an overnight thing, I assume that everything can happen and they stay in your guest room, your stateroom, or yeah, your guest room. Stateroom's a cruise. Here we are. but they will just kind of, I guess, bring their own entertainment. I don't want people to be weirded out about it because obviously these people are vetted. Everything looks good. And I assume you had no problems with your particular sitter at all.
I actually used her twice. So I had 2 days booked because I was on a 7-day trip. And it was actually the same sitter twice. They actually kept us with the same sitter. So that was great. Like I said, I have a 2-year-old, so getting him to like someone and be okay, be okay with a new person, especially on vacation outside of his comfort zone, was a worry for me. It really was like that up until that minute that they showed up. I was like, I don't know how this is going to go. I mean, my son's not in like any sort of childcare normally. He does go to school during the year, but he's used to his teachers. He doesn't see rotating faces all the time. Gotcha. So that was a big worry for me, but she showed up. She was great. She had a teaching background, so that was nice. And she ended up staying in the room with him. They did go out just to get dinner. We stayed at Boardwalk, so they went over to Beach Club, just walked over, all that. And she got them ready for bed. The first night I got back at like 9 o'clock. So he stayed up, but the other night we went was our last night of the trip. So we stayed out a little bit later and she put him to bed and everything, sent me messages to let me know that he was doing okay.
Love it.
Any problems. So yeah, it was really, really a great experience, like from start to finish.
Yeah. I mean, so many questions, but you answered so many good. I mean, that's just a great overview of, you've got a wonderful person who obviously cared for your child, made sure that he was okay, comfortable. Obviously, he wasn't screaming or crying for mom. It sounded like he did well. And you were able to have a vacation. That is so encouraging to know, whether single parent or not, just an opportunity to say, just not that you need a break from your child, we know, but you need a break from your child. You're at Disney. But the fact that she was able to feed, little question here, and it's not important. So, but I assume, did she have her own way of getting into the room? Like, is she given a card or is she given a magic band? How does that kind of work?
So I gave her an extra card and let her guest know that she was there. So that way, if there was an emergency and she got locked out or something like that, that she could go and get another one if she had to.
Gotcha. Prior to, you had not met this person before, but you obviously used her, like you said, for 2 nights. Do they send you kind of like a here's a person that you may be interested in, or how do you kind of get to know this person prior to you inviting this person into your life and into your family?
So they did not assign her until we checked into the hotel, because when you check in, basically you give them the information of when you want them booked, all that sort of stuff. You give a credit card for down payment, well, for a hold, not for a down payment. Sure. If you no show or if you cancel late, you know, they charge you. But they didn't charge anything ahead of time anyways. So they sent me who, like a name of who it would be. All their people are CPR certified, background checked, first aid certified. So all that stuff I wasn't really worried about, because that had all been done. They sent me her name and that was it. So I had no idea what age I would be getting or anything like that. You know, they are over 18, so it's never somebody who's not responsible, but
right.
I wasn't
bring the make your friendship bracelet kit. Yeah,
exactly. So, and with me, my son has his own stuff, you know, they didn't have to bring anything, but they do bring activities, stuff like that. If you request it, older kids, they'll take them. If there's movies on the lawn, things like that, they do take stuff like that.
So, I was going to say, does it have to be restricted just to the room, or you mentioned they can go to boardwalk and such. Can they, I guess, are there real limitations? Obviously, don't really go off property or anything of that nature. You don't really want the kid going in a car. A walk across a bridge from boardwalk to beach club sounds wonderful, actually. I've been in a few times. It was great. But are there limitations to where they can go or where you can ask your child to go with this center?
So you can go anywhere. They can go in the parks, but you have to basically buy them a ticket. So that's the stipulation there. You have to buy the person a ticket, but it is available if, say, you wanted to send your kids to a different park for the day with them, that's doable. They also can go anywhere, basically anywhere on property.
Yeah.
As long as, I mean, I don't think they can use their own cars.
Right. Like, yeah, I wouldn't think so. No, but that's cool.
Liability safe.
What a cool babysitter service. Hey, let's go on the Skyliner and just fly around for a little bit while mom's in Epcot doing your Epcot stuff. Well, that sounds like he must have had a great time. I wouldn't want a babysitter to kind of just watch after my every needs and take me everywhere. That sounds cool, Kira. So first night, obviously, like you said, got home a little bit earlier, or got back to the resort a little bit earlier than stayed out. Do you pack anything special? Like, do you say, here's what he eats, here's anything like that? Or is it just kind of, you know, y'all figure it out?
So you do have to purchase their food. So they don't buy it. So I did mobile orders both nights.
Cool.
And got him his order, got her order, you know, what they wanted. And I basically just said, you know, when you're ready, when you get over there and you're ready to check in, just let me know. Checked in on my thing, sent them the receipt. But like, my son has allergies. So they asked that up front. And like, I gave her the Benadryl and said, here it is, you know, take this with you anywhere. Here's the stroller, here's pajamas, here's diapers, here's all that stuff. I kind of had all that ready for her. So you can pack whatever you need to. And like, we were in a villa, so we had, you know, snacks galore and everything. So I was like, here's his snacks. If he wants snacks, he can go get snacks, because it was literally vacation.
yep. I love it. All right, so you've got me convinced. Yeah. Let me ask, though, as the mama, maybe night one is different than night two. How often did you check in?
Night one was probably 4 times.
And in how many hours?
6 or 5.5.
Not bad. Once an hour-ish. Yep. Okay. Very good for you. Night two.
Twice.
Love it.
They're been a little bit more relaxation happening that night.
Exactly. I understand. We can talk about that on another call here. Stay tuned for Kira's adventures in Epcot or wherever she decided to go. Maybe Disney Springs. I don't know. We'll talk about that now because that's the big part of this as well.
Right.
The kid obviously had a great time. That's awesome. Little Prince deserves to have a good time. Mama deserves to have a good time. Where does mom go without kids knowing that your child is safe with a babysitter? I mean, obviously you said you had a, you went with some friends or family or whatever you went with. Do you just say, I'm going to stay locally, like the closest either resort or park? Or do you really just try to go and say, you know what, I am on vacation and my child is taken care of?
So for me, mm-hmm. since Epcot is my favorite, and I do enjoy adult time at Epcot, mm-hmm. My best friend was also with me from California, so the two of us, she's also a huge Epcot fan, so the two of us went and did our normal thing that we used to do before kids.
Nice.
So we, you know, drank and ate around the world.
We're adults here, it's fine. Yeah, that's awesome.
Rode Spaceship Earth a couple times, relaxed rather than with a little one to watch and worry about, and just stuff like that. So we did stay closer because I was at Boardwalk and it wasn't a far walk. We did plan on going to Hollywood Studios at some point during our back and forth, but because of the rain a couple of weeks ago, kind of ruined a few things. So we just stuck to one park rather than flushing it between the two. But so I did choose a closer place. But the second night we did go to Disney Springs.
Cool.
And stuff like that. So that was a little bit further out and not so close.
So with, you know, now we kind of get into, and we've done an article with, or an interview with Casey about adults at Disney and stuff, but it is important again, because we may have some adults who are watching this and saying, you know, I don't know. I don't know if I should, or I don't know what it's like to do with Disney as an adult without a child. It's been so long. Just what are some of your recommendations as far as places to go if you are adult? I know Epcot, you know, obviously for the showcase and the food and the wine and just the festivals that they have, Disney Springs also entertainment and stuff. Did you find yourself riding rides like you were a kid again? Or was it, you know what, I am a mature mom now. I am going to take part in more of the adult stuff. Or did you just turn into a princess all over again?
No, I'm a total princess. Disney is my playground, literally. I used to go for dinner every night when I lived, you know, 2 seconds away. So it's not, for me, I did that as an adult. So the only difference now is that I have a kid to be responsible for.
I have to go back to somebody, yes.
So that's the only thing that's different. As for rides, I mean, I did rides just like I normally would, but for me, and I try to tell my clients this all the time. I'm like, relax.
Yes.
Don't try to fit everything in because you're going to be disappointed at the end of the day.
Absolutely.
You're going to say, I forgot something, or I didn't get to this thing, or, you know, this line was really long and we waited, or, you know, like all those little things add up at the end of the day. But if you just take it in stride and kind of just enjoy it.
Yeah.
There, you'll have a better time because you're gonna just relax. That's the biggest thing.
What is, and again, we're talking about Kids Nite Out, yes, but Adults Nite Out is just as big a part of this. What is something that you experienced this past trip as an adult that maybe you just didn't enjoy as much as a kid, but now that you, I don't know. I'm there's two ways you could say this. Having a kid and saying, oh, such and such would love this. Or just, oh, as an adult, I really love this. I mean, now that you have that alone time, because again, if our people are taking advantage of this and they're saying, I just haven't done it as a kid in so long, what is something that an adult will experience that it's like a refound love for all over again, just in an adult perspective?
So for me, so the thing that I appreciated more this trip with my kid was Dino Land at Animal Kingdom.
Nice.
My son is big into dinosaurs right now. Like, that's his favorite thing on earth. We walk, talk, eat, sleep dinosaurs 24/7. So, as rundown as it can look sometimes and things like that, and a lot of people have hatred for it, I really appreciated it with him because he loved it. I mean, that was probably close to his favorite thing, was all the dinosaurs, even in the gift shop, like all looking up, like all the dinosaurs.
Great
on the
stuff in there.
Mm-hmm. Which I honestly had never looked up in that store before.
Yeah, fun. Yeah.
Thing he noticed, and I'm like, what? What are you talking about? And he ran around that store for a good half hour, just like yelling everything on the ceiling, all the different dinosaurs that were on the ceiling. And everybody just got a kick out of it because he was just so excited. So that was something that I appreciated as an adult this time.
Right.
As for something that I probably didn't appreciate was like, so my first trip was as an adult. I was 25 when I went on my first trip to Disney World. And it was my mom's also. My mom's
first trip. Oh, wow. Okay. So first timers going. Yes. Fun.
I got to get everything done thing.
Drives up crazy.
And I missed so much. And I think that's where my appreciation for Epcot came in, because after that, I became a pass holder because I was living in Florida. And I started to like really look at the details in Epcot. All the building details and all the different things about the different countries and learning the history and all that sort of stuff. And that's definitely the thing that I appreciate as an adult.
Mm-hmm.
And I think as a kid, I wouldn't have seen it that way. And even on my first trip, I didn't even see it that way.
Yeah.
So those little things are what I love.
Yeah.
That I really still enjoy. Like
the little details. And I've said that about Epcot before, you know, what it lacks in kind of the big name attractions, and they do have Soarin' and Test Track and all that, but let's be honest, when you compare it to Magic Kingdom, you're not going to Epcot for attractions. And as I have said about Epcot, you almost have to put yourself in the experience. You have to go in there with the mentality, slow down, take your time, and let it kind of just evolve all around you. Because it is almost like a sensory type park where you can't just rush from country to country. You can't just rush from Test Track over to Soarin'. You can, but you're not going to enjoy Epcot. You're going to be like me and just be a grouch about it. But if you slow down like I did the last couple of adult trips, you can see Epcot in a wonderful light. And slowing down and taking it all in, the little details, whether it is, you know, something as small as the Eiffel Tower in Paris, but then just seeing the detail in the Mexico Pyramid, or seeing, you know, Japan and Italy, and just even just the music and the sight. Slow down, take your time. And as an adult by yourself, without a kid that is either bored, crying, hot, or whatever, yeah, it's totally different. Yeah. But I agree with you. You have given us so much good information. And again, you're a wonderful agent. You're a fun teammate because you have wonderful, you know, tips and help for all of us. And I know your clients love you to death. And being from the Northeast, hey, she's the only one there. So she got a wide net to kind of tag. But talking about Kids Nite Out, if somebody, I guess this is the last question that we could ask you about, Akira. If you had one just piece of recommendation or advice about this Kids Nite Out service, if somebody was saying, I'm thinking about it, but what is just the one piece of advice that you could give somebody when it comes to this incredible service that is obviously being offered? What would you say to that one person?
Take the night off.
That's great.
Don't feel guilty. Take the night off. It's worth the money. It's worth the time that you get in return. It's really, I felt that mom guilt, and I've always felt that mom guilt because I'm the only parent. So it's really hard to push that aside.
Right.
And luckily I had my best friend holding my hand and saying,
helps.
Like, just do it. Like, you need to do it.
Yep.
That is definitely the thing that I say, like, just pull the trigger, do it. You're not going to regret doing it. It's so worth it. Like, and I've definitely started to tell my clients about it and say, you know, take a date night, take a couple hours to go and relax, go, you know, have a couple drinks, go experience Abracadabra, you know, go to, you know, Trader Sam's, go places that you can't necessarily enjoy with the kids around. Go do those things.
Well, what an awesome piece of advice for anything. Take the night off. That was perfect. Well done. I mean, that's why she's one of the best. And, you know, off, you know, camera here, Kira also works in healthcare, being from the Northeast. So just God bless you. Thank you for all you do for that and everything that I know you've been through in the past 18, 20 months. So just appreciative of our healthcare workers. Kira, obviously, this is a fun side job, but she does take care of people in the real world. So thank you for being one of the best of us, not just agent-wise, but just people-wise and just serving us in these times. So thank you for that, genuinely. And now we'll get back to me and you picking on each other for the Epcot love. But again, I've run her contact information. Obviously, this woman knows her stuff. She's willing to try new things, and you need to try new things. You need to try a Kids Nite Out. You need to try a new restaurant, a new park, a new attraction. That's what Disney is. It's always constantly changing, always evolving, and you can be a kid, again, without your kid. And if you have questions about that, contact Kira. She knows what's going on. So, Kira, you have been awesome tonight. I appreciate it. Thank you so much for everything you've done. For everybody else, thank you for watching, and for your just – being a believer with us, for your love, for using us during pandemic times, normal times. We are thankful for all of you out there for being our guests and our believers. We will see you all real soon. Open the door, get on the floor. Everybody wants the dinosaur. Open the door, get on the floor. Everybody wants the dinosaur. Open the door, get on the floor. Everybody, and you've got your believe ears.
I do. And I wore my spirit jersey because I was like, I was going to wear my Epcot shirt, but then I was like,
This is only the third person now that has said something about Epcot to my face. I'm done with all of y'all.